الحمد لله رب العالمين، وصلى الله وسلم على محمد وآله وصحبه وسلم. إن شاء الله تعالى we're going to continue from where we left off. From the book of الشيخ عبد الرزاق البدر حفظه الله تعالى, important lessons for Ramadan. And in this chapter, the Sheikh is talking about the remembrance of Allah during the month of Ramadan. So he said, Allah commanded his believing servants in his book to remember him often, standing, sitting, and on their sides, in the mornings and evenings, in richness and poverty, in health and sickness, private and public, and in all situations. He connected to this a splendid reward, great recompense, and a beautiful abode. He, the Most High, says, يَا أَيُّوَا الَّذِينَ أَمَنُوا اذْكُرُوا اللَّهَ ذِكْرًا كَثِيرًا وَسَبِّحُوهُ بُكْرَةً وَأَصِيلًا هُوَ الَّذِي يُصَلِّي عَلَيْكُمْ وَمَلَائِكَتَهُ لِيُخْرِجَكُمْ مِنَ الظُّلُمَاتِ إِلَى النُّورِ وَكَانَ بِالْمُؤْمِنِينَ رَحِيمًا تَحِيَّتُهُمْ يَوْمَ يَلْقَوْنَهُ سَلَامٌ وَعَدَّ لَهُمْ أَجْرًا كَرِيمًا. We who believe remember Allah with much remembrance and glorify His praises morning and afternoon. He it is who sent His blessing on you and His angels to ask Allah to bless and forgive you, that He may bring you out from the darkness into light. And He is ever most merciful to the believers. Their greeting on the day they shall meet Him will be peace. And He has prepared for them a generous reward, means paradise. In this verse, there is an encouragement to make much remembrance of Allah and clarification of the great reward and extensive good that results from this. Allahu Akbar. One of the scholars, one time, he was traveling around and he came across this man. This man, he was handicapped. He didn't have any legs. He didn't have any hands. And this man, he was remembering Allah, subhanAllah. He was remembering Allah, subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this man, he was saying, Alhamdulillahi alladhi faddalani ala kathiri min khalqihi tafdila. So this man, he was saying, praise be to Allah who favored me over so many of his creation. Allahu Akbar. So that scholar, he was extremely amazed by this man. So he approached him. He said, I am really shocked. I see you have no legs. You have no hands, nothing. And you are saying, Alhamdulillah, that has favored me over so many of his creation. Please tell me what are these favors and blessing that Allah has given you, and He did not give others. SubhanAllah. But listen. He said, جَعَلِ لِي لِسَانًا دَاكِرًا. Allahu Akbar. He granted me a tongue that remembers Him. Allahu Akbar. How many people they have tongue and they don't remember Allah? How many? They remember the dunya. They talk about the dunya all the time when they are together, but they don't remember Allah. They remember Allah only when someone dies. Inna lillahi inna raji'un. And this read the ayah from Surah Al-Baqarah. Huh? So that's when they start remembering Allah. Okay, then when was the remembrance of Allah before that? You see. So that is the first thing. He said, He granted me a tongue. He bestowed upon me a tongue that remembers Him. جَعَلَ لِي لِسَانًا وَقَلْبًا شَاكِرًا. And a heart that is grateful to Him. A heart that is grateful to Him. وَبَدَنًا عَلَى الْبَلَاءِ صَابِرًا. And a body who is patient upon the trials and tribulations. Allahu Akbar. SubhanAllah. So that scholar, he was so amazed. He told him, you are the king. SubhanAllah. Nobody is like you. How many people they have wealth?
They don't have no problem, physical problem. They go to the gym every day. They're very healthy. But they don't have this ni'am. They don't have this blessing. You know? They don't remember Allah. They don't thank Allah. They're always complaining. Subhanallah. Even if Allah gives them the whole world, they will say, I don't have anything. Na'udhu billah min dhalik. Some people are like that. It's like they're drinking from the ocean. Because when you drink from the ocean, you're never going to quench your thirst. The more you drink, the thirstier you're going to get. Likewise, those who love the dunya, they're like that. They're never going to get satisfied. The only place that's going to satisfy them is the grave. When they put the dirt on top of them, that's the end of it. إِنَّ لِلَّهِ وَإِنَّا رَجَعُونَ. The Shaykh said, in this verse there is an encouragement to make much remembrance of Allah and clarification of the great reward and extensive good and result from this. He's saying, هو الذي يصلي عليكم وملائكته. He it is who sends his blessings on you and his angels too. Ask Allah to bless and forgive you. In this is a great encouragement to remember Allah often. And the best type of inspiration to do this, this means that Allah remembers you, so remember Him. Allahu Akbar. A similar verse to this, He's saying the Most High, كَمَا أَرْسَلْنَا فِيكُمْ رَسُولًا مِنْكُمْ يَتْلُوْ عَلَيْكُمْ آيَاتِنَا وَيُزَكِّيكُمْ وَيُعَلِّمُكُمُ الْكِتَابَ وَالْحِكْمَةَ وَيُعَلِّمُكُمْ مَا لَمْ تَكُونُوا تَعْلَمُونَ فَاذْكُرُونِي أَذْكُرْكُمْ وَاشْكُرُولِي وَلَا تَكْفُرُونَ. This is Surah Al-Baqarah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, the meaning of which, similarly, we have sent amongst you a messenger, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, of your own, reciting to you our verses, the Qur'an, and sanctifying you, and teaching you the book, Al-Qur'an, and Al-Hikmah, the Sunnah. And teaching you that which you used not to know. Therefore, remember me, and I will remember you. And be grateful to me, and never be ungrateful to me. A person reaps what they sow. Whoever remembers Allah within themselves, then Allah will remember them. Allahu Akbar. As it is in Hadith Qudsi. وَإِنْ ذَكَرَنِي فِي مَلَئٍ ذَكَرْتُهُ فِي مَلَئٍ خَيْرٍ مِّنْهُمْ. And when he remembers me, my servant, remembers me in an assembly, in a gathering, then I will remember him in a gathering better than them. What is the gathering that is better than them? The angels. Allahu Akbar. So when you remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in a gathering, human, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will remember you in the gathering that is better than them, the gathering of the angels. Allahu Akbar. And this is a great encouragement to remember Allah often. And the best of inspiration to do this, this means that Allah remembers you, so remember Him. Similarly, we have sent amongst you a messenger, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, of your own, reciting to you our verses, the Quran, and sanctifying you and teaching you the book, the Qur'an and the Hikmah, the Sunnah, and teaching you that which you use not to know. Therefore, remember me, I will remember you. And be grateful to me and never be ungrateful to me. A person reaps what they sow. Whoever remembers Allah within themselves, then Allah will remember them. Whoever remembers Allah in a gathering, then Allah will mention them in a gathering better than that. And whoever forgets about Allah, then Allah will abandon them. A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajim. Subhanallah. Imagine if Allah abandons you. Subhanallah. Where are you going to go? Where are you going to go? Allahu. That's why Allah said, whoever Allah guide, no one can misguide. No one can misguide. Even if the whole creation get together to misguide this person, they will not be able to, because Allah guides them. And whoever Allah leads astray, nobody can guide him. Even if you bring all the scholars of the world to sit with this person and give him
advice and all that? Nothing. And look, subhanAllah, what Allah said in Surah Al-An'am. Surah Al-An'am. About the kuffar. Because the kuffar, they would beg Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on the day of judgment to take them back to the world. To take them back to the world. Oh Allah, give us another opportunity. We will do good deed. Look what Allah said. Alimul ghayb. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He knows the unseen. He said, فَلَوْ رُدُّوا لَعَادُوا لِمَا نُهُوا عَنْهُ وَإِنَّهُمْ لَكَاذِبُونَ. And even if we were to take them back to the world, they will go back to what they used to do. Subhanallah. And they are indeed liars. Because Allah knows the end result. He knows everything. Allahu Akbar. See, when someone does not wish for guidance, no matter how hard you try, you can never guide them. And if that was the case, Abu Talib, the uncle of the Prophet ﷺ, would have been guided. But Allah said in the Quran, إِنَّكَ لَا تَهْدِي مَنْ أَحْبَبْتِ وَلَكِنَّ اللَّهَ يَهْدِي مَنْ يَشَاءُ. You Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, you will not be able to guide the one you love, even though he's your uncle. And he was very loyal. He was very loyal to the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. And he used to defend the Messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم from the mushrikeen. And look what he said. Look what he said. He said, إِنِّي لَأَعْلَمُ أَنَّ دِينَ مُحَمَّدٍ مِنْ خَيْرِ الْبَرِيَّةِ دِينَ. He said, I know for sure that the religion of Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم is the best of the religion of the creation. الله أكبر. لولا الملامة أو حدار مسبة لوجدتني بداك سمحا مبينا. He said, if it was not for the tribe, the خاندان, the tribe, they will criticize me, right? And they curse me out. I would have submissively followed you and believed in you. Allahu Akbar. SubhanAllah. But he was afraid of the tribe, tribalism. You see, this is a barrier that prevented him from accepting Islam. Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, he was by his head, and Abu Jahl was there. The Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, he said, Ya Am, oh uncle, say La ilaha illallah. I will defend you on Yawm al-Qiyamah. Because if you have Tawheed, the Prophet ﷺ, he will intercede for you. He will intercede for the people of Tawheed. But he cannot intercede for the Mushrikeen. So the Mushrikeen, they were there because of the bad influence of those Mushrikeen. They were telling him, no, die upon the religion of your forefathers. She shirk. So he died upon the religion of his forefathers. A'udhu billahi min dhalik. See, this is the uncle of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allahu Akbar. Al-Hidayah is from Allah. Wallahi. Abu Muhammad al-Maghribi, al-Ustad Abu Muhammad al-Maghribi, he shared a story with us. He said, a taxi driver, he takes people from Jeddah to Masjid al-Haram every day, every single day, for the last 25 years, he never entered Masjid al-Haram and prayed to rak'at. Never. Hidayah is from Allah. Wallahi, Hidayah is from Allah. Look at this man. La hawla wa la quwwata illa billah. He goes to Masjid al-Haram, I don't know how many times a day, at least about 4 or 5 times a day, because he goes back and forth. He shuttles between Jeddah and Mecca. And Mecca is not very far from Jeddah. You see? Every single day, this man, he takes those who want to perform Umrah, want to perform Hajj, those who want to go to Masjid al-Haram, every single day. But Allah did not give him tawfiq. He did not give him success and tawfiq to enter and pray to rak'at. He's deprived, subhanallah, of this khair. La ilaha illallah. And our noble brother, Abdullah, he is not with us this year. He couldn't make it. But he told me a story about a man in Oregon, Muslim man. He said the masjid they used to be at, this man, he will come after the people are done with the iftar.
and he will wash the dishes. He will wash the dishes every single day. But he will never pray. And you know, subhanallah, look, this man, he used water. Subhanallah. He uses water every single day. But he cannot make wudu without water because Allah did not give him tawfiq. Allah did not give him that success. He has water in his hand. But he cannot use it for wudu. He will use it to drink and other than that. But for wudu, he will not use it. So he never prayed with them. He said, this man, he never prayed with us. وَلَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا حَوْلَ وَلَا قُوَّةَ إِلَّا بِاللَّهِ. You see? That's why you should always ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to guide you. Because al-hidayah is from Allah. Guidance is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Yes. The statement of al-allama al-shaykh Abd al-Rahman al-Sa'di rahimahullah ta'ala resembles this. The least of this is for the servant to cling to the remembrance of morning and evening after the prayers and at certain incidents and situations. They should be consistent at all times and all situations, for verily, this is worship through which the doer surpasses others. So if you want to surpass others, make dhikr. It is relaxing, leading to the love of Allah and knowing Him, and aids in the performance of good and in refraining from improper speech. I ask Allah the Exalted and one free of all imperfections by His beautiful names to make me and you from the men and the women who mention Allah much, and from those whom Allah has prepared forgiveness and the great reward. Verily, He is able to do all things and the one who answers the supplications. Ameen ya Rabbi. So that's the end of this chapter. We're going to stop here. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant us all beneficial knowledge and righteous action. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. Sallallahu wa sallam ala Muhammadin wa alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam.